Hey Fab Girls, if you're anything like me, there may have been a time in your life that you feel like you just wish you were taller because that way you could look more stylish. Well, I hear you, and I'm also short, and so I created a series specifically for short women sharing my styling tips that I have found have not only worked for me, but for my many clients that I have worked with. So today I'm doing a recap on that six-part series and just giving you some of the highlights of the series. So sure, you can go and watch the whole series, but you can also watch this one just to recap on the top tips so that you can look stylish and fabulous regardless of your height. If you're new to my channel, if you're coming back again, welcome. It's so wonderful to have you here. I'm Tracy Gold. I'm a personal stylist, fashion designer, and YouTube fashion influencer, specifically for women over 40. And ladies, I am super passionate about sharing fashion tips with you that help you look and feel fabulous, regardless of your age and your height. So if you want to get more tips like this, be sure to subscribe to my channel, hit that subscribe and that little bell, that notification bell, and that way you will be notified every time I upload new videos every Tuesday. So ladies, I'm super excited to show you the overview of the six-part series, which is entitled Styling Tips for Short Women. So I'm just going to give you some of the highlights, but be sure to go and check out the whole series and really do a deep dive if you haven't seen them already. Also to say that at the end of the video, I'm going to tell you about the free downloadable quick tip sheet that you can get for free on how to dress taller. And ladies, throughout this video, if you see some things that you really, really like and you want them for yourself, then I have put the details in the description below with links. And if there's not the exact item available, I've put some other suggestions to make shopping much easier for you. So ladies, my number one most important tip when it comes to dressing when you're short is to define your waist. And this is actually important for all women. It's the best thing that you can do for your body, but it is especially helpful when it comes to short woman dressing, and I'll tell you why. The thing is, when you wear boxy things, it actually can make your legs look like they start at the end of the top or the dress that you're wearing. However, when you define your waist, it makes your legs look like they start from here, and that way it makes your legs look a lot longer, even if they aren't. Okay, so ladies, now what do you do with all your baggy things? Because I am absolutely sure that you have quite a few of these in your closet. So I'm going to show you one of my favorite tricks that I do for myself as well as for my clients all the time. Okay, so you can see here, this is one of my dresses, but it's rather baggy, okay, and it has no shape. And also because of the length, it really, really makes me look quite dowdy. Now, it's a beautiful dress, but it's not fitting me properly. So look at what happens when I do this. Once again, I'm telling you about the belt, okay? But look at how the belt transforms this. And ladies, you can do this in your own closet as well. You can take those things that don't have much shape and you can belt them. Ah, now look at what this looks like. Can you see the difference? Ta-da! It's taken a shapeless dress, okay, and a printed one at that, because when you wear prints, you need to wear them in fitted clothing. I'll get to that later on. But really, you want to be working with something that is fitted in your waist and defining your waist so that your legs look like they start from here. Waistbands and how they can make you look taller instantly. I know they can, and I'll show you how. So don't worry, it can get really confusing. Mid-rise, high-rise, I'm not sure what it is. But what you are looking for is either a mid-rise or a high-rise waistband in your pants, and I'll show you why. But also don't worry, because I'm going to talk you through if you've got a tummy or not a tummy, because there are some tips and different ways that you can work around this. So if you have a fairly flattish tummy, ladies, then you're going to want to go for a high rise. Okay, so you can go for mid as well. I also wear mid and I really love mid, but high is also lovely because I'm going to show you a trick in a moment. It really works nicely because it does give you that waist definition. What it also allows you to do is to wear shorter tops. Okay, and the shorter tops is very key because when you're wearing your high-waisted pant, plus you're wearing a long top over that, ladies, look at this. This is not making my legs look longer at all. So what I want to do is I want to wear shorter tops, and it allows me to do so because I have the higher waisted on underneath. And I can still lift up and still my belly isn't showing, which is great. Now, if you are able to tuck your tops in, so if you feel comfortable and you feel like your tummy is flatter enough, absolutely fine. This is something that I do, especially with high-waisted pants, because I find with high-waisted, it actually looks better when it's tucked in. Not to say that I don't wear these with the top over it, because I do sometimes, but I just find that you see, there we go, gives me far more waist definition and makes my legs look longer. So ladies, the most important thing when looking at your perfect length of pants and jeans is to avoid anything cropped or three-quarter. So here you can see the jeans that I'm wearing, and this works whether you're doing jeans or pants, all right? But the jeans that I'm wearing, look at the one leg, okay? And this is full length down to just as long as it possibly can go. Bearing in mind also, ladies, I am wearing flats, which is really the telltale sign, because anyone can look taller when they're wearing heels, but I am actually wearing flats. Look at the difference here, and then look at the difference when it's cropped. Okay, so look at that and tell me, which do you think makes me look taller? Well, in my mind, definitely this one makes me look shorter. And the reason being is because the eye goes to where there's skin. It automatically draws to where there's skin. And that makes me look shorter. It automatically cuts my length. Now, what do you do with all those millions of pants that you have already in your closet that are three-quarter? Well, I have two little solutions for you. So the first solution that I have for you is to wear an ankle boot that actually bridges the gap between your shoe and your jeans. Still not ideal, but at least you're not seeing skin, and that does help. And of course, for fall, it's quite easy to do. Now, ladies, if you have a pair of black pants that are three-quarter or cropped, then it's going to look even better, because that way you're creating one long line. So you'd go black pants, black shoes, and it will create one long line and make your pants look like they're longer. Now, this is another option. You can actually wear long boots over your cropped pants or jeans, and that way you won't see skin at all. This is my preference as opposed to doing the ankle boot thing, but once again, it depends on which shoes you have in your closet and what you feel most comfortable with. Once again, this look is going to work even better if you're wearing black pants or black jeans and black boots. That way, or one long line is going to make you look taller. Now, to further illustrate how important the length of your dress is, I have put on one of my dresses from my collection that, okay, it is quite big for me because it's a size too big for me, but it's also way too long for me. And ladies, look at what this looks like. I mean, especially when it's in a print, it's really going to make you look dowdy if it's the wrong length. Now, if I play around with the length, look at how different it looks. So if I take the length to just a little bit up, so I kind of go 2 inches up, which is going to take it just below my knee, okay, look at that, versus I take it above my knee, now look at that. Okay, so although it is much better to be wearing things above the knee, as you can see here, still, I'm very cognizant of women who don't want to show their knees. I think especially as we get over 40, we sort of think, maybe my knees don't look quite like they used to, and you don't want to show them, and even maybe tights doesn't really do the trick for you. Well, then just below your knee, ladies. And I mean really just below. Even on your knee can work, but just below is going to make a big difference. Look at the difference again. Look at that. Okay. You can see that it's not that much below my knee, but it really is making me look dowdy. Whereas when I take it up an inch, like about 2 inches, it really, really does amazing things. So you want to make sure you want to play around with your dresses and get your right length, but I'm telling you, just below the knee is actually as long as you should go when it comes to a short dress. We're going to talk about full-length dresses in a moment, but I really want you to see the difference that it makes. Look at how it changes the dress completely and the look completely. And it's really going to make a difference in your length of leg. Now, also just quickly, a little tip is that you notice that I'm wearing ankle boots, and I get a lot of questions around ankle boots and how to wear them. Well, one of the best ways to wear them is if you're wearing them with dresses, and especially if you're going to wear your dresses just below your knee, then it's a good idea to wear the same color tights and the same color shoes. That way you're creating an elongated line. One long line is going to make you look taller instantly. Asymmetrical lines make you look taller instantly, and if you can find a sweater in an asymmetrical line, it will do the trick. Now, you may have never thought of this before, but it is one of my absolute favorite tricks as a short woman, and it's one of the reasons why I designed the sweater like this, because it tricks the eye. It going down like that automatically makes my legs look longer. Now, you can also do this with sweaters that have peaks as well. So they can be high, lows, they can be all different kinds of things. In fact, you can do it in dresses too. I have plenty of those available. Now, the other thing that is also something to bear in mind is you do want to look for prints and patterns, because prints and patterns are going to make it much easier for you to wear a fitted top. And remember, in the beginning of the video, I mentioned that the fit of the sweater is very important. You want to define your waist. An asymmetrical line isn't going to work if it's just one big baggy top or sweater, and especially if it's chunky. So a print and a pattern just helps disguise a few little lumps and bumps here and there. So first up is a block heel. Ladies, this is a game changer, because if you're trying to wobble around in very skinny heels, I don't know about you, but I've never been able to stylishly walk in those kind of shoes. But a block heel, completely different story. So that allows me to have a little bit of extra height without the discomfort. Also, what I find, I don't know about you, but I've definitely found that when it comes to boots, which is one of the reasons why I love fall and winter, is that it gives me more stability. It gives my foot and my ankle more stability, which often means that I can go a little bit higher than I would in a shoe. But the thing that you're looking for is the stability, ladies. Block heel stability. And in fact, these shoes, I think I bought 4 or 5 years ago, still wearing them, recently had them repaired, and still loving them. Now, these shoes I can easily wear with a pair of leggings, with jeans, and with dresses. And in fact, if I'm wearing them with dresses, then often I'll wear the same color tights as the shoe, and that way it makes my legs appear longer than they really are. Just a little bonus tip. Another thing that I want to mention that really is a pointer when you're shopping for a pair of shoes, because sometimes you don't really know if it's going to be comfortable. You may go into stores and it feels fine, but then you get walking in them and they're not comfortable. Too late, you've worn them, you can't take them back. So one of the things I always look at is how much of a progression is the heel. So how high is the arch, essentially? If I put my hand in there and I can feel that there's quite a dramatic arch, even if it has a block heel, it's not going to work for me, because that dramatic arch is going to hurt my feet and my back. So you want to look for something that's a little bit more gentle. That's going to make sure that it's going to be more comfortable in the long run. The other tip that I found very useful is to look for a rubber sole and a rubber heel, because this makes a big difference. It also creates a bit of a cushion effect as you're walking. So even though these are quite high, I find them really comfortable because of the rubber sole. The rubber heel. Also, notice that it is a solid heel once again. Ladies, I can't tell you enough. A solid heel is the thing that I always look for. But rubber and solid combined, really awesome. You may even be able to go a little bit higher without the pain. Before you go, I do want to make sure that you get your quick tip sheet on how to look taller instantly how to dress taller. So all you need to do is click on the link in the first few lines of the description, super easy, and it will take you to a dedicated page. And that way you can just put in your name and your email address and it will be on its way to you. Also, be sure to stay there for a little bit because I have put in there some resources, some videos, some outfit ideas, etc. So you may want to check that out too. Thanks for watching, ladies. Let me know in the comments below which are your favorite tips and which have been your aha moments. I would love to hear from you. And don't forget, no matter what your age and no matter what your height, you can look stylish and feel good doing it.